This is Charlie Flo, World Sports Show. I'm here with Sarah Gorden, who's picked up by Chicago Red Stars. What's this event been like? Just hearing your name, some nerves going into the draft.
A lot of nerves, honestly. It was so up in the air. I didn't know what was going to happen at all. So it was kind of a surprise when I heard my name, but so exciting, so exciting.
Now, being picked up by Chicago, Roy Dame's very good coach. What do you know about the Chicago, team so far? You made the playoffs last year, so definitely a team with a lot of youth.
Yeah, I mean, they have a great team. I actually played for Rory in club on Eclipse, so I have some experience with him coaching, and I've always loved the way he coaches, but they have a great team, and they're going to be great this year, so I hope I can help that.
Pretty nice to play close to home because you'll have a good fan base.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, as I was saying in there, it's a dream come true. There's nowhere else that I would want to be. All my family can come to every game, so it's going to be great.
Especially with Chicago this year going to be playing at Toyota Park. I mean, that's even better probably.
Yeah, that's definitely an upgrade from their old field, but that's just so exciting. I think that'll be such a good atmosphere.
Now, you've played mostly in your college and center. You just told me a few minutes ago before this interview that you sometimes can play the wing. What are some of the areas that you're comfortable, or is it more of a, hey, you're willing to do anything type of thing?
Well, I would say I'm most comfortable with anything 1v1 defending. That's what I'm strongest at. And just any kind of chasing down a ball, really. Speed is, probably my biggest strength. But I love playing on the outside because you get to go forward a little bit more and join the attack.
So, sorry to throw you in the bus, but you said speed is your biggest strength. What's your weakness, then? I don't expose you.
I'll have to get back to you on that one.
Interviews? I'm just kidding. Speaking in front of crowds. That's what you were saying is we talked for this interview. I didn't realize that you did broadcast, you do sports broadcasting. So it's kind of natural to be behind a camera. What has that been like? Just, how's that helped? Has that helped you in the soccer, being in front of crowds at all?
Yeah. I mean, it's different. It's very different. I think that with soccer, I have more of a peace of mind. No matter how many people are there, I can just zone in on my game. With broadcasting, I've had to focus more, and it's taken a little bit longer to get into it, but obviously I haven't been doing broadcasting as long as soccer.
Chicago might have you do double duties,
That would be amazing.
So there's been a lot of the web broadcasts, like some of the teams have done, so it's definitely a fun thing that with social media and the internet, you're able to put your work out there, and I'm sure that's a neat part about being a sports reporter, that you're able to just almost be a one-person type of show.
Yeah, definitely, and I think now that I can say as a professional athlete, it's even more of, when you're a broadcaster and you are a professional athlete as well, that's more of a way people look at you and say, wow, they really do know what they're talking about, just because they have that.
That's pretty cool. Yeah, professional athlete. Has that sunk in now? You're a professional soccer player. You got the scarf and everything.
It has not sunk in at all. It feels surreal.
Some pretty big teammates. You got some World Cup players like Julie Johnston, Nair playing goal. Do you know any of these players at all? Have you had any experience to know these players?
I do not know them personally. Obviously, just watching them on TV, but I think my favorite part will be learning from players like that.
Well, thank you for your time. Wish you the best of luck in Chicago, and we'll talk to you soon.
Thank you so much.